Not only was there a new repaint in the 2072 in that four-unit lash-up down at the north end of the yard, but notice also the CSX, large CSX on this 7045 on the nose. All you can see is the C. Very unusual to have one that large. Yesterday, while we were in Corbin, Kentucky, we saw this 8586 heading north, spliced in between two Seaboard SD50s. Today, the same unit is heading south with another Chessie SD50. In just a few moments, you'll see this three-unit lash-up pass a northbound coal train, again with two more SD50s. The SD50s really reigned in the Atlanta area. Well, there they are, four Chessie SD50s all in one spot in Atlanta, Georgia. Who would ever thought they would see the day? Don't you just love those GP16s? Sort of brings back the memory of the Western Maryland chop noses. As we close out our segment in Atlanta, we find ourselves in beautiful downtown, right downtown Atlanta. There's Ted Turner's Cable News Network building. As this train is waiting for a Norfolk Southern to cross the diamond just on the other side before it heads out. We are now in the small town of Cordele, Georgia. The auto carrier train that you just saw, along with these two yard engines, made up a good day of train watching in this small town. In just a few moments, a southbound will be passing across the Norfolk Southern Diamond. It's now the 23rd of December, and here we are in Waycross, Georgia, home of the CSX General Electric units. This train, northbound, heading to Savannah, with none other than a Chessie unit and a Family Lines cab. The locomotives you see here are being scrapped outright by Scrap Steel Processing Services. All of the locomotives are Seaboard System GEs, with the exception of two Chessie System SD40s, 7518 and 7565, which were wrecked while on the Seaboard last year.
Thank you.
After completing our tour of the CSX Locomotive General Electric facility in Waycross, we find these three locomotives doing load tests just outside the shop area. We are now down at the Waycross running repair facility and ready track. This is our first time visit there, and was there a lot of power? As we prepare to leave Waycross for Jacksonville, we find this six-unit consist made up of three GEs and three switchers spliced in the middle, getting ready to leave on a southbound to Jacksonville. We followed this train almost to Jacksonville, where we later see two of these three switchers sitting in Moncrief Yard. We are now in Jacksonville at the CSX main headquarters, where we see the new dispatching facility being built, which will be in operation August of 1988.
Yeah, 221,
The Orange Blossom Express heading towards Orlando is the only thing running late in the day on Christmas Eve day. On Christmas Day, we traveled out of Florida from Jacksonville and headed north. What you are seeing now is Savannah, Georgia, and the yard in Savannah, where everything is shut down for the holiday. We even find a B&O caboose in Savannah, along with a CSX yard switcher. After leaving Savannah, we headed north and wound up late in the day in Cayce, South Carolina, a suburb of Columbia, where the CSX yard is located. At Cayce, we found 10 locomotives sitting idle for the holiday.